Windows 11 ships with a way to speed up your laptop's performance absolutely for free. So the question is, if you're not using this method, why aren't you? Hi everyone, I'm Mark Hockman with PC World, and today we're going to be talking about Windows 11 specialized power management controls, which includes a way to speed up your PC. So let's dive right in. Windows 11 settings menu includes this submenu, the power and battery submenu, which leads here to the power mode setting. Now, on Windows 10, we refer to this as the power slider, and it lived down here in the taskbar. But in Windows 11, it's been banished to the settings menu. Now, the way to optimize your PC is to simply change this drop-down menu from recommended to best performance. Because, you know, why not? Now, you'll find with some laptop makers, maybe a Dell, maybe a Lenovo, that they have a choice of optimizing their laptops, and they may choose to optimize them for battery life, they may choose to optimize them for performance, or they may simply select somewhere in between. So, for example, you might find on some laptops that this is the recommended setting, and this is changed to best battery life. But on other laptop makers, such as Microsoft, this choice becomes even more interesting. And that's because most Surface devices are shipped in this best battery life recommended mode. And the reason for this is probably fairly obvious. Microsoft envisions a world where Surface devices roam between meeting to meeting and run apps like Word and PowerPoint. But in a case where a laptop is at home and connected to a power charger and might be running a few games in the evening, you want to have a situation where you can optimize for best performance. Now, the question you might be asking yourself is, what does best performance mean? And it varies from laptop to laptop and from benchmark to benchmark, but in this case, we can look at one, and this is the Cinebench benchmark, which accompanied the review of the Microsoft Surface Book 3. And in this case, Cinebench is running all threads and all cores at once, so it's equivalent to, say, a Photoshop. But we can see that in the default mode, it generated a score of 693. In best performance mode, it generated a score of 750. We'll save you from doing the math. It's about an 8% difference. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, okay, 8% is not that much. But again, remember, it's free. It's adjustable by a single click. And so we think this is significant. Now, at this point, you might be asking yourself, is this overclocking? And if you've heard that term before, you know that it means that it pushes a CPU or GPU or memory beyond the thermal limits that are set by the manufacturer. This is not overclocking. Overclocking will invalidate your warranty or potentially invalidate your warranty. This will not. What we're doing here is simply adjusting the performance and battery life parameters within what the manufacturer, in this case, Microsoft, set up. Now, that sums up the way in which you can optimize your PC, but if you wouldn't mind sticking around just for a couple more minutes, I wanted to show you a couple more features of the power and battery settings within Windows. And there's two things that are interesting. One is what we call smart charging. Smart charging is most commonly found on Surface devices, I think. It's also, I think, typical of Windows 11 and not Windows 10. What it does is it takes the conventional wisdom of charging a battery in a laptop or a smartphone and automates it, essentially. And that's to say that this, with a smartphone or a laptop, you'll get the most battery life over the life of the device if you don't fully charge the device or you don't let it fully diminish to 0%. What this does is it charges the laptop up to 80% and no higher, or in this case 79%, preserving the longevity of the battery over the lifespan of the laptop. Now, you might be asking yourself, okay, I want to go on a business trip though. I want 100% battery. How do I do that? Well, it's going to change from laptop to laptop, but in this case, it's controlled by the Surface app. An app that you probably don't go to that much if you actually own a Surface, but in this case, you can go to the Surface app, select pause, and it will in fact charge your battery up to 100% over the normal charging period. The other thing that I wanted to show you is the battery usage. And battery usage isn't something that you need to look at, but it's interesting. It'll show you the usage, of course, of the laptop itself, but it'll also show you the usage of the individual apps on the machine as well. In this case, you'll notice that Cortana is generating a 75% usage, which looks a little extreme, especially because I don't use it all that much. So from my standpoint, I'm going to, once this video is complete, probably turn off Cortana and save myself a little battery in the process.
So that's a quick tour of the power and battery subsystem, along with a tip on how to improve the performance of your PC. For more Windows 11 tips and tricks, visit PCWorld.com or keep it tuned right here to PC World's YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.